mountain, loved it like always, but you know what was really cool? It said 30 minutes, we waited for 10, and the attraction itself was like 10 or 15 minutes. So the attraction was longer than the line. Walking through the queue area, you can actually see there's no one here. Look at this. There's no one in the queue area with us. And as I'm walking through, basically to ourselves, David, thought for you at the moment, it's gonna be changed to Tiana. I'm looking forward to it. I'm pretty sure you're looking forward to it as well. We're gonna miss Splash Mountain, we will. We've talked about it before, but really looking forward to Tiana. My question is, can you see this turning into a Tiana's kind of area, like super easily? Because at the moment, I can. I can, like right away, when I see it with nobody around, this almost already feels like Tiana's area. And there's a lot to change, there is. But I can really see that first step. David, what do you think?
Definitely see it with the outdoor, grassy nature vibe. I feel like you can see yourself in Louisiana, in the country, on the bayou, riding down those streams and lakes. Definitely a lot of similarity here from what I would expect for the Tiana attraction, so we'll see, but I can see it.
The line is so short that they're not even using the twirly queue right here. That's what I'm calling this area here, a twirly queue. They're having guests go right from the entrance right there and walk straight into the building. That is the kind of line we're talking about. And to me, that it was 10 minutes we waited and there was a little bit of a filling over there of the line. So this has gotta be 7 minutes, 5 minutes. I'm telling you, unbelievable. Time right now, and I wanna make sure I get it exactly right. It's 8:19, park closes at 9 p.m. So 40 minutes left, 5 minute wait for Splash Mountain. The wait here says 20 minutes, but I almost guarantee it's less than half of that. I mean, that goes to show it is a little bit of a unique time and those waits are overestimated. So if you see it longer and it's later in the evening, don't be afraid of it. Here's another look, just about 35 minutes before Magic Kingdom closes, okay? This is really interesting. You can see early December, not that crowded all around this entire area. I really wanted to test this theory because I figured, you know, we were at Epcot the other night. I thought to myself, okay, this is really cool. Like I didn't realize that it would get this low crowds, especially during this time. You know, there's a lot of pent up demand to go to Disney and all around. I can totally understand that. I think we all can. But this is really cool to see. I do want to note something. It's not like this all day. I cannot stress that highly enough. During the standard hours, I'd say anywhere up to about 2 hours prior to a park closing, it's crowded. It's crowded, just as we've seen the past few months. It is crowded. It's great to see that it's not just Epcot. I really wanted to test this, and I'm glad we're here testing it. I'm gonna go all the way to close and continue seeing how the crowds are. Let's go on more rides. Now, this is new. Take a look. We've got this bush barrier between Crystal Arts and the shopping area right here on Main Street, USA. We used to be able to walk this way just a few days ago, so seeing it blocked off, that's new. I wonder what's going on back there. Something new. David, what do you think that they're building behind this bush barrier?
It's possible they're thinking up maybe a new parade concept where maybe they come through back here or go out this way, because we saw the balloon man hide back here as the parade was going down the main street. Who knows? We'll see.
I love that idea. I wish it were true. I wish it was. I think it's probably gonna be like another shop, another store, or maybe just general renovations. I don't know. We're all hoping for parade though. We're all hoping for parade. Dave, we're at Aloha Isle. It's gonna be your first time trying my favorite holiday drink so far. Are you excited?
I am excited.
Okay, you think you're gonna love it?
I think that these are some good options on that dish, so yeah, I'm excited to try.
Does pistachio try, does it sound like weird or does it sound like super good?
I don't often think combinations of things sound weird when there are two things I like, and those are two things I like, so. It sounds pretty good to me.
I hope it's your new favorite. David, you've tried a little bit of the ice cream alone, you've tried a little bit of the chai alone, and you've tried a tiny bit of the mix together. What do you think?
I think it is a strange individual flavors. The ice cream by itself, the tea by itself, are slightly strange, but the combination of the two does have a nice combination to it. I would have expected to like them more individually than I do, but the combination, again, unexpectedly nice. So I'm gonna keep trying it, but overall, I think you do have a winner here in terms of a unique Dole Whip float type option. I don't know if it beats the classic for me. I do really love that classic, but not bad.
After you're done with it, I'm gonna ask you that question again. Okay. All right, Dave, you're just about through it at this point. What do you think?
Very solid option, and it does get better as you mix it up. I'd love to see those larger cups to be able to mix this in more thoroughly, because the more you can get it blended together, in my opinion, the better it is. That being said, I do prefer the original to this one. I wouldn't say this is one that I feel the need to get regularly. I try not to get the original too often either because it's so much sugar, but that original is so delicious in my opinion. Get it with pineapple juice, get it with the vanilla, or get it with the pineapple ice cream. So, so good. This one's solid too, but I feel like this one's probably more rare for me. and probably not as ideal as the original, in my opinion.
Okay, one more ride to end the night. Time is now 8:55, so 5 minutes left in the park. Standby says 20 minutes. 20-minute wait. I'm walking in. It's just kind of a walk-in. I'm clicking start. We're going to see how long it takes. It's been 7 minutes at this point. We're just about halfway through the line, so this one's going to be a little closer to the 20, but still, it goes to show. Wait times are overestimated and the crowds are lower, and I'm looking forward to, once we're done with the Jingle Cruise, seeing what the crowds are all about once the park's officially closed. You know, I think it's been years since I've been on the Jingle Cruise, like, in complete darkness. This is going to be great. It's the Jingle Cruise, complete darkness, and I was wrong about that halfway point. That was, like, the three-quarter way point, because we're now at, like, 10 minutes. It's pretty fast. Total time, 10 minutes and 45 seconds, literally walking on the boat. Right now, here we go. That on Jingle Cruise. The park is officially closed at this point. We are making our way out, but take a look, even right after closing, very few people around. Look at this, nobody. But then once you get on Main Street around the hub, I can already see them. I can already see the people. Now we've been taking photos, having a great time. It's now 30 minutes after park closing. Still plenty of people here, but you can easily get that fantastic family photo with the castle just like that. It's magical. I love it. I really do being able to close the park here. We are not even close to the last ones. There's lots of other guests all around us, and there's a long line for Emporium. There's a long line for Emporium still, and it's 46 minutes after closing. Still a lot of people here. We'll definitely catch that monorail for the end. We will, no doubt. But we're gonna catch one more of those very special pops of the fireworks as we see one more transition. Just like that, we saw that pop of the fireworks as a transition to the Christmas sweater. I'm calling this projection the Christmas sweater. I love it so much. Ah, such a great feeling. Yay. Now I should note that the transitions happen every 15 minutes. So on the hour, 15, 30, 45, and then on the hour again. So if you're looking for that transition to pop, it's every 15 minutes. And occasionally they're a few minutes late. It's usually very, very close though. The other night when I was here, it was right on, it was like to the second. Tonight it's like 2 minutes, totally fine. It's around that time. Overall, an incredible night. And I've got to tell you, David, I want to hear your thoughts too. Lower crowds in the evenings, is it worth it? So I know that, you know, crowds, we have different, you know, comfort levels, and that's fine. That's a good thing. We all are different. David, when it comes to these lower crowd levels, is this something that you'd be like, okay, this is a little bit better for me. I like it even more.
It depends on the day you're comparing it to. Some days I would say are more crowded than this one. Some days I'd say I've seen are less crowded than this one. So all depends what you like and what you're comfortable with.
Perfectly said. I think everybody's got their own comfort. If you are looking for lower crowds though, try later at night. It's just one of those little secrets that I'm finding. As the holidays progress here, there's no doubt we're gonna see more intense crowds in the evenings. Just found out we are on the very last train. So for now, wanted to keep you updated. It's the 1 hour after park close is the final monorail. You can still get back to the parking lot. However, my understanding at this time again can change, we found out. Ferry back to TTC. That will still run even after the hour after park closing. So that's the update for now. Thanks so much for being a part of the magic with us today. It was so much fun sharing it all with you. Until next time.
Have a magical day.
See you real soon.